Hi, this is Dr. Martin, and welcome to my channel. It's been a while since we actually posted a video due to the fact that we were busy with other programs. I was actually busy posting videos on the other channel. If you haven't seen the other channel, make sure that you check it out in the description section. The name of the channel is Ending Early Raps with Elisha Phiri. I'll leave the description section there. I simply teach people about ending apps and how you can make money from those apps. So without any further ado, let's take a ride. This is a question that I extracted from 2023 Science Paper 1, and it's basically on current electricity. So here's the question. They're saying the figure B8.1 shows an electric circuit with 5 ohms resistor connected to a 12 volt sample. Calculate the reading of the instruments labeled A and V. So the instruments that they're talking of include this one and that one. So for you to be able to answer these questions, you have to know the instruments that they're talking of. So instrument A is actually an ammeter. Then instrument V is actually a voltmeter. So now if we have identified those instruments, what are their readings? You need to know an ammeter measures the amount of current passing through a particular point in the circuit. Then V measures the voltage across a component in the circuit. So let's answer this question. They're saying calculate the reading, so they want us to find the current through this point. So what equation do we use to determine current? Research solutions. So that's that's B, right? I skipped A, but we'll get to A, don't worry. So A is an ammeter. So we say an ammeter measures current. So we're gonna find the amount of current through the ammeter by using the equation. Current is given by voltage over resistance. So we can collect data. So when we check on the diagram, the voltage is actually 12 volts. So we write the voltage is equal to 12. And then the total resistance that is actually being offered by this resistor here. And that's the only one that we have in this section. So resistance is equal to 5 ohms. So we can actually plug in those values. We say current is equal to voltage is 12 and current, that is resistance. Resistance is equal to 5. So 5 into 12, that's 2. Remember a 2. 5 there, you can divide 5 into 2. So yeah, so that's 2.4 amperes. So the reading here is 2.4 amperes. Let's check out this one. Let's check out this one. So for the second one, we're saying we are resolving the reading across this component here. So we say voltage is given by current times resistance. So we're going to say voltage is equal to, what you need to know is this is a series circuit, and for a series circuit, once you determine the amount of current passing through a particular point, then you need to know that current is the same at all points. So if we have 2.4 amperes through that component, then we know that the same amount of current is the one that is passing through this point. Hence, we can take it that this current is 2.4 as well. Then we're going to multiply by the current by 5. So we're going to say current is 2.4 times resistance, which is 5. So voltage is equal to
1.
We can actually find that 2.4 times 5, that gives us a 12. 12 volts. And so just like that, we are done. Let's look at the last question. But before we look at that one, we can as well answer this one. It says that Ohm's law. What does Ohm's law say? So you can actually write this one. You say resistance is equal to voltage over current. That is actually Ohm's law stated. Or we can actually state it in words by saying Ohm's law states that the current through a conductor is proportional to the voltage across the ends of that conductor. And that holds true as long as the temperature of the conductor remains the same. I will repeat that. Ohm's law states that the current through a conductor is proportional to the voltage across its ends, provided that temperature is the same. So as long as temperature remains the same, then voltage and current are directly proportional. Very simple, right? That's smaller. They're saying, what is the cost of using resistor R for 6 hours a day for 30 days if power costs 15 per kilowatt hour? So first of all, we need to resolve the power that is being dissipated by this resistor. So how do you find power? So we make use of this equation. We say this is, so that's the last question. We say power is given by voltage times current. So power is equal to, what's the voltage? The voltage through that one is 12 and the current is 2.4. So power is equal to 12 times 2.4, that gives us 28.8. But what you need to know is this. The power that we make use of when we are determining the cost of electricity, look, it should be in kilowatts. So what we do is we will convert this one, which is in watts, into kilowatts. So we're going to say 1,000 watts equates to 1 kilowatt. So what we have is 28.8. We don't know what it equates to, so we get an x term. An x terms that we are going to have 1000x, then 28.8. We get rid of the 1000 this side. We are applying mathematics here. So we have 28.8 divided by 1000. And that gives us 0.0288 kilowatt. So then, if this is the one, then we're going to say that power is equal to 0.0288 kilowatt. Okay, so we have determined power and we're going to make use of it to resolve the total amount of energy that was actually consumed. So energy is given by power times time. So energy is equal to power, that is 0.0288. And what was the total time? We fall back on the equation here. And it says it was used for 6 hours a day for 30 days. So we're going to multiply 6 hours by 30. So 6 by 30, that gives us 180. Amen. So the total energy that was consumed, that it would be 180 times 0.02288. And we have 5.184 kilowatt hour. That's not it all. We now need to calculate the cost. Since we have found the energy, the total energy, then we need to find the cost. How do we do that? We're going to pick this last part for the same 1 kilowatt, 1 kilowatt, 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 15N. Okay. So this is what we're going to use to determine the cost. Then we're going to say, okay, since we have 5.184 and we don't know how much it will cost, we're going to write x. Then we will cross multiply x times 1, that will be x. Then 5.18 times 15. That gives us 77.76. And that was actually the cost of the electricity that was consumed. As simple as that, we are back on track. So make sure that you happen to turn on the notification bell so that any time I happen to post a video, you don't miss any. Thank you so much for watching. God bless.